Hello everyone, welcome back to Baby Bunting Reborns. I haven't been with you for so long, it feels really weird. I know there was a time that I wasn't on YouTube, and so I don't know why it feels so odd when I miss, like, I think it's been a week or more. But it did, I felt really strange and disconnected, and I've been trying to catch up on videos and things. Same old story, isn't it? But it's been like there's just been so much stuff going on around me, good and bad, all fine in my life and my little family. It's school holidays here now, so I've had a lot of lots of turns of grandchildren sleeping over and things, which does take a fair bit of time, as you can imagine. So there was that. What else has there been? Oh, so many things. My doll club has had a very sudden death. One of our very important people in the club died very suddenly, just at age 54. So that has really shaken things up and made life a bit more complicated. I'm actually the president of that club, so I've had a big responsibility to try and contact people and find out about funeral arrangements, all that kind of thing, and lots of phone calls. And I've been trying to, I can't remember what I've said to who, but you know, it's just taken a lot of time and a lot of sadness and worry and concern for her family, all that kind of stuff. So basically those are the things that have kept me away from YouTube. Plus my head has been ridiculous for 5 days now, and so I'm not feeling well. I'm a bit dizzy and still got the pain in my head from a migraine, so I'm not anywhere near 100%, but you know what, I just keep pretending and hope it goes away, and I guess it will. But what you are looking at here is more gorgeousness and cuteness than I can even bear. Now admittedly I am the mother, so I may have a bit of bias, but I'm hoping you can see a fraction of the adorableness and the cuteness that I'm looking at. I've had these little Spanish outfits for a long time, way before I had these babies. And I've just been doing lots of sorting. Oh, that's taken time as well. It all started with glass bottles, didn't it? It always starts somewhere. So I started to sort out my glass bottles, and then I thought, oh, I should wash these ones. It's been ages that they've had the fabric softener in there. So I've got them all washed, all put into a lovely big plastic tub, and they're all safe and clean now, so I'm happy. But of course that led to other things, didn't it? It led to me buying extra tubs and putting one tub for shoes, baby shoes, because of course I'm demented about baby shoes. And what is the other tub got? Oh goodness me, oh, I've got bonnets and I've got nappy covers in another one. So that sounds easy, doesn't it, girls and boys, I should say, girls and boys, but it means I have to pull apart my whole doll room to get to the place where all those things were kind of stacked, and they were organized, but just not as organized as I like, because one of my favorite things ever since I've been little is to organize things. I love it. I love it. I don't know what it is, but it's fun, and so that probably took me 3 days just to do that little bit. Doesn't sound like much, does it, girls and boys? But really, truly, it was a lot of work, and I'm very happy with that. So anyway, I've put them in, my babies, in these two adorable little Spanish knit outfits. I'm doing kind of the reverse of what you guys are doing in the Northern Hemisphere, because you're all using up, you know, your summer outfits in the very last hurrah of your warm weather. And I'm using these two little warm outfits in the very last kind of hurrah of our cooler weather. It's about probably 22 degrees today, Celsius, and so it does get cool still at night and in the early morning, so I don't feel too guilty dressing them up in these warm outfits. And good heavens, they look so cute. How can you not? I mean, it's just irresistible. So there they are, the two babies. So I'm very sorry I've been gone for a while. Probably you guys couldn't care less, but certainly I did. It was hard, really. Every day I wanted to make a video, and every day the time would disappear from under me. So I'm very glad to squeeze this in, because actually it's my youngest son's birthday today, Timmy. He's 31 today, and so I'm going over to his house tonight for a party. And you know that Wednesday isn't my great day because I've worked overnight last night, so I won't be fully functional, I don't think, but it'll be fun anyway. And then Thursday and Friday I'm having my little granddaughter Amelia, who's five, for the 2 days and the overnight, so that's going to be fun, but that means no videos as well. And then Saturday all day is a big meeting at the doll club, so even, you know, Saturday's gone. Sunday, I think some of the children are going to come and visit as well. So there we go, that's the week gone. So I really had to squeeze this in. I really wanted to talk to everyone because I've watched a few videos. I haven't had much time to watch many, but there's just a few answers to tags that I would love to give. So let me think. Oh, the first one was that really caught my interest was Miss Serenity Smith's tag about if you could choose one baby to come to life for 24 hours, which would it be? Well, I'm going to say something really shocking here, and that is that I don't want them to come to life. I've only got two, and I'm really, really glad they're dolls. I love them being dolls. I've had four of my own babies, eight of my own grandchildren, and I love being able to dress them, they stay clean, they don't cry, they don't interrupt me, they lie peacefully all the time, so I'm really happy not to have them come to life. Isn't that awful? I know that's heresy, but still, that's how I feel. So I love and adore them, and that actually leads me to the next question, which was a tag that I think Kelly Girl put out about what's more important to you, excuse me, girls and boys, what's more important to you, the babies or the accessories? So, of course, the babies are important because without them there's no accessories or there's no use for the accessories. So I would have to say for me, I think you may have noticed how much I love baby clothes. So I would have to say that I have collected baby clothes anyway before I had Jonty and Pippa, but I was sending them out with the dolls I make, and obviously I still do that, but now I get to buy them and keep them for these two and for whichever doll comes next that I'll make for myself, because I have a few kits I'm desperate to do when I have time just for me. So I have a lot of baby clothes and I love them, and so I guess the accessories are more important, and yet without the babies there wouldn't be a need for them. So they sort of go hand in hand, don't they? But I am demented about the clothes. And there's another thing I'm demented about, aside from glass bottles and rattles that you already know about, it's blankets. Like, lots of you have this thing, and I don't know what it is. There's a hole in my heart that wants more blankets. So what is that about? I'm not cold, but there's something beautiful in a blanket. So I have a stack of baby blankets, and I try not to let myself buy another one, but I still do. I just bought one the other day when I was out with my little grandson Dougie, and I just bought another one because it was gorgeous. So, you know, I'm going to have to buy a new house to put the blankets in. That's how ridiculous it's getting. But the good thing is that at least they're baby blankets and they're not huge, because I did go through a phase of buying blankets for grown-ups, because I just love pure wool blankets. So I have a few of those, but I had to stop collecting those, obviously, because they just take up too much room in my linen press. So I only have a limited number of those, but the baby blanket stack is growing at an alarming rate. And it just, yeah, so are the baby clothes, although because I'm running out of hanging space and folding space, that's already slowing down, so that's put a stop on me. I don't like to be overwhelmed with stuff. Some people would say I am already compared to what they do, but for me it's fine. Everything's tidy and put away and easy to get to, so I'm happy with what I've got. So that's the answer to Kelly Girl's tag, which is really no answer at all, because I love the outfits and the blankets and the babies. So that's a bit of a cop-out. Now, the third thing I wanted to talk about was something that Ines mentioned a couple of videos ago about different genres in collecting and what sort of videos we do like to watch, and, you know, what things we should say and shouldn't say and how we should say them, all that kind of stuff. So I would just like to talk a little bit about that, because I actually agreed with everything that Ines said. Don't know what that makes me, but it doesn't make me, I don't know what, it's just, I do agree with her. I feel that the videos that I like to watch are the videos of real people, people who talk about all sorts of things in their life, people who use the dolls as a backdrop, but also talk about interesting things at the same time, because obviously I love the dolls or I wouldn't be here. I'm not so, like, for me, I don't do any role play. All I really do is walk past the babies and just look at them. I just love to have them dressed and just love to look at how amazing they're real and beautiful they look. So that's the pleasure I get. So I don't do role plays. I just dress the babies when I want to do another video. So they stay in their same outfits until the next video. And then I get the fun of deciding what I'm going to put them in next, which I just love. So yes, for me, and like for Inez, I like opinion pieces. I like when people talk about their real life, about what's happening with them. I like to see their babies. I love to hear them talk about their babies and see how much they love their babies. So it's all rolled into one. But I must admit, I'm not so drawn to channels where everything is bright and chirpy and happy all the time, because to me that doesn't seem real, and I like real people. I like people who aren't afraid to say what they believe, people who stick up for what they believe in, that kind of person. Someone who doesn't, someone who's kind and caring, but still has strong opinions. That's what I like to watch. But, you know, it's fine. If you're not like that, then I just think, oh, well, I won't watch. That's fine. You know, I think everyone has that choice. What I really don't understand is people who watch something when they don't like what you're doing. I think, life's too short. Why would you do that? Just so that you can be mean. Like, I don't get it. I don't want to be mean to anybody. So that's the bit I don't understand. I don't suppose you can hear my phone in the background, but I'm trying to ignore it. Anyway, so that's sort of my feeling on what Inez said, that I do enjoy when people have opinions, and I don't like anybody who's mean or unkind or uncaring. I'm just not interested in anybody who's nasty, because all it says about that person is that they are, well, there's something wrong with them, because you don't need to be unkind to somebody else. Probably they feel a bit unhappy and unkind towards themselves and they take it out on someone else. But I don't need to watch that. They need to work out their own problems and figure out how to make themselves feel better without putting someone else down, because it doesn't actually elevate you at all if you put someone else down. You're just as down as anybody else then. So, yeah, that's how I feel about all of that. And thank goodness the phone stopped ringing. So, I think that's probably all I've got to say for now, which is plenty, isn't it? You're probably sick to death of hearing my voice now. Yes, and so I'll probably get organised now for the party tonight. And hopefully, I guess I won't be able to make a video for maybe 5 or 6 days now. But I'll do my best, and I'll tell you how the meeting goes on Saturday, how everybody was feeling after the funeral on Friday, and just stuff like that. It's a really sad time. It's a difficult, sad time for everyone in our club. But I've got the sweet babies who lie here like angels, looking so perfect and so pure in their little Spanish knit outfits. And yeah, so I mean, I could just rabbit on, couldn't I? Because I was going to say goodbye 5 minutes ago and here I am still going. So this time I really will say goodbye, and thank you everybody who watches me, listens to me for who knows what reason. But I'm really glad that you do, and I love having interactions with you. I look forward to checking my comments all the time and seeing who thinks what, and I love to reply. So please, you know, feel free to enjoy my videos if you do. And if you don't like them, that's fine. You don't have to. I'm just one person. There's thousands and trillions of videos that you can watch. So choose the ones you like and get stuck into those. In the meantime, everybody, thank you so much for joining me again, and I'll talk to you in a few days. Bye, and love to all. Be kind to each other. Bye-bye.